Today's SportsWigger tutorial is entitled Client-Side Prototype Pollution via Flawed Sanitization. To solve the lab, we must call the alert function by polluting the object.prototype with a property that is then used to execute arbitrary JavaScript. First, let's open the developer tools and go to the console tab. Let's declare an empty object. Let my object equals curly brackets. In JavaScript, an object is a collection of key-value pairs known as properties. We can declare properties for the object by writing myObject.x equals y, or by using the square bracket notation myObject square brackets a equals b. When we call myObject, we can see that this now contains our declared properties. Besides our properties, the object is also automatically assigned one of JavaScript's built-in prototypes. In this case, my object was assigned the object.prototype. Object automatically inherit all of the properties of their assigned prototype unless they already have their own property with the same key. To see how one of these built-in properties works, we can, for example, call the hasOwnProperty method like so, myObject.hasOwnProperty of x. This returns true because we have previously attributed the x property to our object. This is where prototype pollution comes in. There are several ways to pollute the object prototype. The first way in which we can pollute the object prototype is by using the proto property. We say myObject.underscore_proto_underscore_that_first equals first. We can of course also use the square brackets notation. MyObject square brackets proto square brackets second equals second. The other way in which we can pollute the object prototype is via the constructor, like so. MyObject.constructor.prototype.third equals third. Again, we can also use the square brackets notation. MyObject square brackets constructors square brackets prototype square brackets fourth equals fourth. When we query our object, myObject, we can see that all of the newly created properties have been added to the built-in object prototype. This means that, from now on, all new objects will also inherit these properties. To test for this, declare a new object, let new object equals an empty object. When we query the new object, we can indeed see all of the properties declared earlier. Let's get back to our lab. Go to the debugger tab and select resources.js. We can see two JavaScript files. Go to the search logger filtered file. The search logger function initializes a new object named config with a property named params. The value of params is obtained by serializing the search parameters of the current URL and then passing them through a function called dparam. The dparam function is defined in the other JavaScript file, dparam sanitized. This function is designed to parse the URL query parameters into a JavaScript object. It splits the params string into an array of key value pairs at the ampersand character. Then it splits the current key value pairs at the equals sign. Additionally, it handles complexities in the key names, coerces values to their appropriate types, and sanitizes the key by using the sanitizeKey function. Let's add some query string parameters to our URL to see exactly how this works. I'll say /?a=b and c=d. Copy the object definition, let config equals params and so on, and paste it in the console tab. When we call the config object, we can see that the query string parameters have indeed been added to the params property. Back in the search logger filtered file, we see this if statement. If config has a property named transport URL, the script dynamically creates a script element and sets its source attribute to the value of the transport URL property. Then it appends it to the body of the HTML document. This is where the vulnerability arises. We have found our sink. Seeing how config does not have a transport URL property, we can try to pollute the object prototype with this property and give it a value that will cause an alert to be called when appended to the body of the page. We do this by adding a new query parameter to the URL, like we've seen in the beginning. Proto.transportURL equals testing. When we check the config object again, we can see that our property name has been stripped. Back in the search logger filtered file, we can see the sanitize key function. It replaces the words constructor, proto, and prototype with empty strings. However, it only does this once. This means that if we nest the same word inside itself, we should be able to bypass the sanitization. Let's see how this works. Copy the function and paste it in the console tab. If we call sanitize key of proto, it returns an empty string. However, if we nest the word inside itself, something like this, the function will only find this proto text as being a bad property. It will replace it with an empty string, and the result will be proto. This means that we have bypassed the sanitization. All that's left to do now is to pollute the object.prototype. Change the URL to bypass the sanitization. If we call object.prototype, we can see that this did not work. We have to try every manner of notation, like we've seen in the beginning of this video. Let's start with the square brackets notation. This time, when we call object.prototype, we can see that the injection worked. We also get a new error that we haven't seen before. The browser tried to access the slash testing page, which does not exist. If we now go to the inspector tab, we can see that a script was added to the page because of the code we've seen earlier. The script contains a source element with the value of our injected property. Finally, we need to see what value we can add to the transport URL property to call an alert function. This is an XSS injection, so we can use PortSwigger's cross-site scripting cheat sheet to search for script SRC. We get our payload, data colon text slash JavaScript comma alert. This payload uses the data scheme to tell the browser that the URL contains inline data rather than a reference to an external resource. The MIME type of the data is text slash JavaScript, and the actual JavaScript is this alert function. So, when the browser creates the script element, we will call an alert function instead of navigating to a certain page. When we refresh the page, the alert is called and the lab is solved. This is it for today. See you next time!